By the age of 33, most boxers have long since hung up their gloves. But last night, Leeds boxer Tom Collins stepped into the ring to defend his European light heavyweight title against the Dutchman Pedro van Raamsdonk. At stake, the chance to fight for a world title, the dream that's kept him in boxing for so long.
Well, it's the big stepping stone to a world title. It's everything. It's as simple as that.
It's not my ability what fails me, it's just maybe bad luck. There's a lot of luck to do with it as well as ability.
At his level, indeed any level in professional fighting, there's no such thing as a soft touch.
Pedro van Raamsdonk!
If Collins wins tonight, he's got a world title fight lined up. If he loses, it could be the end of his career.
The Lonsdale belt holder, the present European light heavyweight champion, with 23 wins, 14 losses, one draw. From Leeds, please welcome Tom Collins!
I've known Tom Collins. Tom Collins has been coming here from about 1981, but I've known Tom Collins far longer than that, through his amateur days. Tom is very local to here. He lives in half a mile radius of the pub. And I think I've known Tom Collins since his self was about 13 or 14 years of age. He didn't start as amateur until he was 19, but I've known him from being about 13 or 14 as a local kid.
You know all about the Raamsdonk fight, your next fight, that's a mandatory defence. The money's not exciting, but it's a mandatory defence. We had the pickings off the Kayla fight, which was a voluntary defence. Now, I've been down, last Friday I went down to see Frank Warren. Thank you very much. Thank you. And I signed the contract, and we went through the whole situation, and the news is very, very good. I'm glad to be able to tell you. He's halfway through negotiations to bring the IBF champion, Williams, and you might smile at that, having been halfway along that road before, way back. But his negotiations are fairly well on the way for him to come into London in November. So all you've got to do now is beat Raamsdonk and beat him in style. And it's very heavy odds that that fight is ours.
And he's still up for a world title, and he's knocking everybody out. You know what I mean? It's best we have a player.
Stan, after this fight, if it all goes down well, if he gets the right result, I can guarantee that the world title shot's there.
The world title shall be there.
Oh, well, Williams' fight will definitely be on.
When he fought Tom Moody, devoted it the best fight of, I think it was 1986, was it? Correct me if I'm wrong. Can you remember?
I don't know, to be honest. I remember.
The best fight of the year. Tom Collins is no mug. He'll give this guy this. Forget about this Van der Plonker.
Not saying he's a mug. You know that is, George.
No, yeah, it's only one in it, George. You know what I mean?
I'll tell you what, Vince, if Tom Collins had been a London based fighter, he'd have had his world title chance by now.
Well, I do. Yeah, I think so.
Because the Yorkshire fighters, especially the Yorkshire fighters, they always get the end of the stick. You must agree with me there.
I agree, Charlie.
Because they've got the same connections as them down there, Dave. That's all. You've got some old people.
Well, that's it. It's lucky in one way that he's got Callaghan as his manager.
How would you rate Trevor?
I rate Trevor as the strongest manager up north. It's just unfortunate that he's up north.
Oh, hello, is it Simon? Oh, Trevor Callaghan, Simon. I wrote some time ago and sent a cheque for the renewal for Terry Mintus's seconds licence. Well, the moment we saw him punch a bag, he could throw punches that some fighters will never throw in a lifetime. He could dip his left shoulder and throw left hooks. Beautiful, it was a treat to see. So the talent was natural, it's inherent in the man. But There's a long way to go, and there's been a lot of hard work to work from then to what he is now. He'll start favourite. I mean, Raamsdonk is generally rated in the various ratings issued on European boxing around number 12 or 13, four or five better calibre fighters on past records than Raamsdonk. I think we have to think that he's been a little bit lucky to get the nomination as official challenger. But he's a very good box fighter, and Collins will start favourite, and his experience should, and his powerful hitting should take care of him late in the fight.
Yeah, when I saw Randstad, or whatever his name is, I can't pronounce it, I never really took any notice of him, but I just glimpsed him, and I don't think he was, well, to me, he wasn't all that impressive, but he's got there to challenge me for the number one, so I've got to take him seriously.
Well, I think he knows, well, he's had it proven to him at long last that he is a winner at this, in this very violent game, and I think that has given him a great deal of confidence. It's shown in his recent contest. He is a far more confident fighter and a more confident person.
I never took it seriously all those years back. Maybe that's why I was having my ups and downs. But it's now lately that I've really, you know, taken it seriously. And I've progressed. I've won the European title, what Dennis Andrews couldn't do. And now I've just got to do the same what he's done, win the world title. But first I've got to get over this defence. And once I have, and I know that I'm going to go for the world title, I know that I'm going to win it.
I mean, everybody in boxing, they've known for very many years what a talented fighter he is. But he's chosen personally to play it a little bit low profile and hasn't cared to move around very much, and certainly on the few times that I tried to get him out and mix and be seen and meet people in the early days after his first British title win, he certainly he wasn't very comfortable doing it. He would rather have been at home, it's certainly safe to say that.
We don't classify him as a doorman or a bouncer by any means. He's a celebrity in his own right. And he does attract customers for us. And working here, or being here, I would say, for him works in his own good as well. He did a bit of PR work for himself and for us as well.
I just enjoy the work. I just like being around people. I like the accent. It's the place, really. It's, I just love it. Well, my secret is that is to be aware of what's going around you, and just make sure that everybody's happy and enjoying the night, you know, night out. And if there's any funny business, well, I'm there to sort that person out. I just talk to him, take him to one side, and just tell him what's what. If he goes back and do the same thing, I just tell him to leave. Because most of the people who comes in are there. They recognise me, they know that I'm a boxer, so they don't take any liberties.
He's a doorman like all the rest of us. He gets paid to do his job when he does it. And that's it. We can talk to him. Spent a lot of time talking to him. We don't need him. Not anymore, anyway.
Yeah, I don't approve of any of my fighters working as doormen. However, persuasive they are with their voice rather than any physical contact, and most boxers aren't interested in showing what they can do out of the ring. They've nothing to prove there, but of course you can always get the little Friday night fella who's had one too many maybe and wants to get his name up in lights, and that's the danger.
Good morning.
How are you this morning?
Feel okay.
Nice morning for your run, my man.
One of these days you'll agree. One of these days you'll agree.
All I have to do is just turn up my muscles in my leg, that's all. I don't have to sprint for stamina. I've got the stamina.
I've spent 10 years of running you on the road. Believe me, it's worked so far. No changes. I ask you for a bit more pace, give it a bit more pace.
Oh, you're going to ask me in care?
Yes, yes. From the comfort of this seat. Well, he's a unique fella. He can be a little bit too easygoing at times, and that can show in his preparation for a fight. So that's where you're skinning your brains all the time in finding ways to work at him to get the very best out of him. I think he spends his money on the females around him, really. The first few years that he... when we used to come back from shows, it could be 1, 2, 3 in the morning when we'd come back from, say, London or Glasgow, wherever he'd been fighting. And the old manager's just tired, just wants to get home to bed, and whatever the amount of money I had to give him, be it £200, £400, £800, whatever the amount was, in those days, I always had to go in the house and pay his mother. He simply used to say, "Will you come in and pay my man?" Well, he's given his belt, the Lonsdale belt, which is a tremendous prize in boxing. It's the one thing apart from a title that with successive wins a fighter can own outright, and he's one of the very few that has won one outright, and he gave it to his mother, the Lord Lonsdale Challenge belt.
Well, he used to have a lot of fights at school, and so I thought, well, if he wants to fight, he could fight in the ring. But I don't like to see Elton fight. I can't watch him. I can come down when it's finished and we all sit down and talk. We don't have drinks because we all are Mormons and we don't drink. So we just talk and laugh until whenever we feel like go to bed after his fight. Well, we are a close family. And he'll come back and we all would talk, and he would bring his, you know, his winnings to me. And, well, that don't say I take over his money, because he would give me what he wants, and I'm quite satisfied with what he does.
Yeah, when I started boxing, I took it up to make a lot of money out of it so that I can help my family. That was the main reason why I took it up.
We're a really close family.
Yeah, we're always together.
We don't need friends, really. We've grown up all together, and, you know, we've played together and everything. And if you'd have seen our house when we were younger, it was like, you know, cowboys and Indians and, you know, people, all of us hanging out of the windows, and it was just us, you know, brothers and sisters. You know,
if anybody had one of the family, just one of them, they'll have to come sit with all of us.
It's just like one big party. When we all get together,
it's madness.
The house, it's just like wall-to-wall people, you know that.
I'm, relieved that you'd finished that other number now, you know, the doorman bit. That area really is not... Let's leave it at this, that it's inappropriate for, you know, one of the country's top professionals to be doing work like that. And I'm very relieved you've finished it. Absolutely no reason why you can't go down there just occasionally socialising, that's okay. Can you agree with me?
I agree, but I can't see the arm in it working as a...
You look at it, you see it from a different angle to me.
I mean, nobody's going to try and cause any bother with me, working it.
Well, we've gone into all the reasons, and suffice to say that I'm relieved and glad you've turned that number in. As long as his road work is right and his sparring is right, in the right type of sparring, and that it's well supervised, that it's just competitive enough without either fighter trying to take each other's heads off, everything else falls into place with his trainer.
It's going like a dream. It's going really nice. He's working hard now, he's getting his strength, he's getting really strong. And he's throwing all his best punches, he's throwing good punches. When I take him on the pads, I can feel all the vibration of his punch going through my body, you know. And he's only hitting the pad. So can you imagine if he hit somebody full on the chin,
you got to have a lot of psychology with Collins. You know, he's, you know, you sort of, you've got to like trick him into doing things.
Tell him it's round five now. We'll get him going.
They're in there to learn. They're not in to kill one another. So I just say to them, look, you know the score, you know what to do. You go in, you're laying off each other. They don't pull punches. They never pull punches. If they have to throw a punch, they'll throw it. You know, and then they'll say to each other, I'm sorry, later on, you know. That's the way. Move inside is jab. Right, time.
Collins has been my main sparring partner, you know, and he's a good boxer, so, you know, you learn a lot in sparring off such as him. If you've sparred with someone so long like I have, I can, you know, we sort of go together, you know, in sparring, you know. I know when to do certain things to Collins, you know, like I'll push him certain nights and we'll take it steady other nights, you know. Some rounds are hard and some rounds are easy. It works itself out. He usually gets fitter than I do, you know, so... But it benefits me as well.
Down that, the wipe is pretty little face.
Not me. Stun about his Collins. Yeah. Stun about his Collins fight. Your next bus.
Yeah. It's all arranged.
It won't be like the last one, though, will it?
No, it's full.
No, I know it's full, but we've got loads of deposits. You know what? Not the last fight of Windsor. I'm talking about that fight in Ireland, when if it's up in Ireland.
This fight will definitely go on. Yeah.
I really can't understand, you know, why he's not being able to fight for the world title. As you know, he's signed up to fight for the world title and fell through. I just can't understand why, you know, he's good enough. He's got what it takes to be a world champion.
I would be very pleased if he could get to a world championship. I think he would be able to win that because, you see, that's all he wants, to fight for a world championship.
No problem. He's the champion. Tom is the next world champion.
Well, the problem would be one of overconfidence, but he looks upon it as this fella is trying to get him off his pedestal. I've emphasised to him, alternate days, I tell him again, without being a wittering old so-and-so, that he's got to look upon this fella as being an absolute, serious, 100% bona fide challenge to his status, and I'm sure he does regard it that way.
Come and get that jab. Double that jab, double that jab. Come forward, come forward, come forward.
Well, what time are we setting off then, Richard? We've got the van booked from 9 o'clock, and we've got to have it back from 9 o'clock the next day.
So we're going to have to set off as early as possible.
No, we're coming straight back.
We're going to get a bird, Sam.
So you're last night.
I think
we should set off about half 10.
Can you imagine about half past 10 is right, Vince?
Half 10, then we can have a drink in Reading.
And I am the European title. I fought hard to get where I got. And I want to get to the top. And the next step is the world title. So this fight is really important for me to win. And I'm going to do it. He's not going to take that world title away from me and take it all the way back to Holland.
Van Raamsdonk, 12 stone, 4.5 pounds. Collins, 12 stone, 6 pounds.
We got any tickets left for rather Mr. Campbell or Trevor Callaghan?
Yeah.
How's that one?
Thanks very much.
Thank you, love. We're going to get a pint then, what?
Yeah, go get a beer.
Oh, yeah, they decked me up.
Have you got old cocker?
Don't blame me.
They don't talk to you neither, do they, down here?
Confidence in
Collins has got to beat him tonight, not Woolley or Woody.
He's got to beat him.
If he doesn't, his career's over, Stan.
We know that, don't we? Of course we know it. I say three. You say four.
Collins is going to knock him out.
Still he might
knock him out, but he'll go for three rounds. If he don't knock him out, he's going to lose.
Well, he says he's going to win. Along with it, we all pray for him. And Tori's sister would fast, because I can't fast, I'm a diabetic. And they fast for him. And because we believe in God and his strength and power and what he can do, we just put our faith there.
We get into any sort of a lead at all. Keep pace with him. If we tell you to quicken it up, you do so.
He's always confident. You know, a boxer's got to be confident. He can't go in half-hearted saying, oh, I wonder if I'm going to win, or, you know, I wonder what's going to happen. You want to say, I'm going to win the fight. That's what you're there for. So you've got to really work yourself up to a stage where you want to kill him in the ring. You feel that's what you should do.
Go in and see what it's made of. And if you can take my punches, you know, he's a good one. And it's going to be a hard fight.
But it's important now for Collins to start looking impressive. He's number two in the WBC, WBA list, behind Virgil Hill and Don Lalonde, who's fighting Sugar Ray Leonard. But certainly a good Collins on his best nights, I think, has got a very good chance to beat Virgil Hill, and he's got to shine a bit here. The last Dutchman he nailed was Alex Blanchard, who hadn't been on the deck before, and he really clubbed him with a right-hand punch. But he's just been going for four rounds anyway, through that typical Tom Collins lethargic stage.
Because I feel the punches for him, do you know what I mean? I really feel when he gets hit hard, you know. But I think I'll stop at home and watch him.
It's like you want to get in the ring with him.
You
and
do.
Give him the other good eyes.
He's really going to have to waken up and, as I say, really try to put the Dutchman under some pressure.
In his 30s like this, it's got to be the final flings now for Collins. He's got to make every punch, I should say, every fight count. Because he could really hear... make a nice few dollars at some time in a world championship fight, but he's got to justify it. He's got to be an attraction anyway for American promoters who want to put him on.
I was in the corner and he was losing the fight. And I don't know, I just said a few words to him. I says, what are you doing? I says, we want to take the title back to Leeds with us. Get it done. I says, you can beat this geezer.
And that first punch there that the Dutchman came out there, he's cut Collins over the left eye. And it's a bad gash too in the seventh. And the referee's got to call the doctor with this one, I think, under European rules. He's saying, where is the doctor? No, he's asking for the second to wipe it first. And then the British board doctor comes up there. And I'm afraid it looks a bad one there. And I'm wondering now whether Collins can go on or not. No, Trevor Callaghan's shaking his head, the manager. No, he's saying stop it. And right at the start of the seventh round, it's a sad defeat for Tom Collins. He didn't do any work in the opening round. He may have himself to blame there, but I must say, Jim, there didn't seem any head work. It looked like a right-hand punch to me.
Now, you've seen it.
Yeah.
Do you agree with what I said?
Yeah.
There's no way I would have been justified overruling the doctor and letting you go out on a muck and nettles basis. Okay?
Yeah.
I just had to be. Is that bad? It's a bad cut, it's a long cut, it's a deep cut, it's jagged, it's like a piece of quarry face, and it's in a dreadfully bad position. I couldn't take the chance of one more shot on it.
Pedro van Raamsdonk, the new European light heavyweight champion, is undefeated in 129 amateur and 12 professional contests.